Hello everyone, we're here again at Roger Gracie Academy in London. We're at my teammate Dean. He's a black belt in judo, black belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu under Roger Gracie. Today I would like to introduce you or demonstrate the two-on-one position, two-on-one variation, and what you can do from the control. Quite often in this position, people get a great angle and they can attack their opponent easily. So the way you do it, as you engage with your opponent, you must look for controlling of the wrist, blocking the elbow, and snatching the arm in front of your chest, pinning the arm off your shoulder and bringing it in front of your chest. Now, the good thing about the two-on-one is that you can set it up on both sides. It doesn't matter with which arm he approaches you. It goes always right-right or left-left. So you can drive towards it. But once you engage here with your opponent, make sure you connect the wrist of your opponent with your shoulder. Lock his arm between the shoulder and your head, almost breaking his wrist. Then the next important point is the waiter. I call this the waiter. So from here, once you put the waiter underneath his elbow, even if you don't peel the arm of your neck, if you just decide to stay here, it's very difficult for your opponent to drag you down. You try to drag him. It's quite hard. I have a good base, good solid position. And if I don't want to go for the two-on-one, he's keep dragging me down, so from here I can just go for the takedown. But if he locks the elbow in and I cannot approach his leg, straight away I continue towards his elbow with my shoulder, walking towards him, pressurize the wrist, pressurize the arm, and bring the arm in front of my chest. Once I've done this, it's very important with your head to lean towards your opponent's shoulder and place your forehead in his ear. Why? Because here he is easily trying to pull guard or move around, so it's quite hard, I can climb up the ladder. Or if he decides to bend the arm, I'll make a lock. Lock your arm, the arm which is going deep under his armpit, lock it under your other arm. And it's very important, the grip, guys. From here, make sure you can control under his wrist. Do not control over. The reason why, as soon as you lock the grip, yep, he can either pull your wrist up or you're working against yourself. But once you lock it in here, it's quite easy to stay on. Next stage, do not remove your forehead from his head. Because here it's very easy. If you move the head, he can attack or he can pull guard or he can square up with you. You don't want this to happen. So position, rotate around, lean towards, lock the arm. Now once you're in this situation, walk away from your opponent, create a space and drag him down. From here, let's get around, control the back. Another one. Here you can walk forward, go to a front headlock. We'll move on from here. Okay, in case he places his forehead in your ear, once you lean towards, you have peeled the arm in front of your chest, you try to lock up the arm, but here it's quite difficult for me. Why? Because there is an obstacle in front of me. I need to clear this boundary. How I do it? With my shoulder, just shove his head away, shove his body away, and place your head back into the good spot. Walk away, drag him down. Control. And move on to something else from this position. Let's try the other side. Block the wrist. Position up. Lock the wrist with your shoulder. Use the waiter. Lean towards him. Walk towards him with your hip. Peel that arm off your shoulder. Lock that arm in. Place the head around. Walk around and drag him down. Up, cover the back. Move on from here. Hilton. Nice heading. Okay. Nice. Change the other side. Nice. Go. And get the back. Nice. Okay, guys, this position is often known, besides the two on one, its very famous name is the Russian tie. Why? Because the Russians are master at this technique. Now, what we're trying to explain here, this is just the basic movement and a setup of the two-on-one. From here, once you establish a good base and good control, there is a lot of variations and a lot of techniques, a lot of positions you can continue and set up from here. The next position you can get to the two-on-one is just from a distance. If your opponent does not want to tie up with you, he's just staying away, your hands and your wrists are going underneath his arms. From here, do not control the wrist. Do not control the fingers, because he can just snap it away. Control just where his palm is with your thumbs. Rotate the arm. Now from here, your choice, just sense your opponent, which direction he wants to go. If he starts squaring up towards his right, just go almost for an arm drag, place your shoulder behind, and go to a 2-1. Or if he goes to the other side, up, switch, move on to the other side. Lock it in, drag him down, and get the back. Okay, I think those are the two situations you can work on for the 2-1. But please emphasize on the pressure towards the opponent. Do not forget the waiter. With this shoulder, drive towards his elbow. You're breaking the arm. Peel it off, lock it in. So that's the base which you must establish. Once you understand the technique and then the setup from there, we can move on towards the next techniques from that position. So in the next videos, we would like to introduce you from the 2-on-1, going to a fireman, or quite often in BJJ, or grappling, or even in judo, people, they grab your gi in position and they extend the arm, they lock it in. I cannot bend the arm, I cannot progress forward. Do not give up from here, just make the connection, jump in and lock this leg around his foot like a snake. Wrap it around, stretch down. From here, bring the arm in front of you and start climbing up the rope. Start climbing up his arm. This one goes behind his back, cut, slice towards his throat and connect the grip. Once you have the grip, you have two choices from here. You either start scooping around him, start jumping around, lift this leg up and scoop him over. The other side. He grabs the gi, he grabs the neck, grabs the core. He's standing his arm, so I cannot bend the arm and bring it in front of my chest. So from here, as you are, jump in. Sneak the leg around, start climbing up the arm. Throw it over his neck. From here, even from here, you can step in and throw back. Yeah. Up, catch the neck, stretch him over, or search for mount. Search for a secure control and position. If he recognizes this position, once you get to the side of him, straight arm, there. From here, jump in, lock the leg around, start climbing up that arm. Once I connect the hands here, I start twisting him up, almost doing the uchimata in judo. If he resists and comes up, do not persist forward. Step in and throw him backwards from here. Here, stretch, step over, and cover. Okay, that's it for the moment. What I would like it to introduce you to. Now in the next videos, we can start progressing up and changing up the techniques. And thank you very much for your time. Appreciate it. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope some of the things which we do will be useful for some of you, and of course will benefit what you do. Thank you very much to Warrior Collective for coming down and recording. If you want to watch some more videos, you can visit the website at Warrior Collectives and you can find some more information. Cheers. Thank you very much.